I don't micromanage Zambia Police Service, first and foremost. Today, as we sit here, they are arresting different citizens, including murder suspects. Even as we sit here, how many times have you heard them come to say, this murder suspect, to details, murdered ABCD? That when he's charged, I'm saying, you wait. They will be told when he's going to court, follow. As the charges will be spelled out, then you will be given those details. You understand? And like I said, there are no sacred cows. I was making an example here of one of our colleagues, a very good friend of mine, former legislature, MP and lawyer. He's in the correctional service after being convicted in the courts of law. I'm sure you followed the details of that case. So if I had the way, I didn't been for the law, I would have said, yeah, my dear friend, please continue being an MP. If the president had the way, he would have said, no, please continue. But it wasn't to be. Why should it be over this individual? Huh? So, here, just be patient. And that's why you heard me warning those who want to agitate and try to force the police to say, no, no justice. What justice? Do you have justice in your pocket? The person is being held and being held for his safety, because those who are saying, why not copper belt? The police determines where they keep their suspects. And no one should question that. How they do their investigations is their baby. No one should question that. So if you want to take law into your own hands and say, remove him, like we saw people demanding for suspects at police stations, they are now in our custody to be also taken to court. So my friend, we don't look at who is who. The law has got no eyes. It's blind. And so those who want to agitate for anything, our men and women are ready on the ground. And they will deal with them like the Inspector General said, ruthlessly. They will be dealt with firmly. We don't want to create monsters in society where the few should torment the majority. Ours is to be with the people. We have to hear the cries of people. People in Chingola lived in fear. And why should we allow the majority of the people live in fear when suspects could be known? And those who are hiding in trenches there and they think they can pop up and cause anarchy, I can just assure them that this time we are not playing. Just as I was giving a friendly warning to cyber bullies and cyber criminals who are propagating falsehoods and hate speech on social media, they will be pursued with aggression. The police will be aggressive this time around, teaming up with Zikta, like the president said. So the president was very clear as commander-in-chief. Ours is to implement his instructions, and we are geared to deal with that. And I did say that those who don't have anything to do with what is going on, you are free to sleep home. Nicely. If you have got a troubled mind, it probably is time to just come out and say, please, I've got information. Not TNT Kambilani. This doesn't require dialogue. Criminality. And those who have got the inferior thinking of that, saying, no, let's invite Scotland Yard. We have got functional institutions of governance here. That's why our correctional facilities are full. Because the police are doing their work, national prosecution authorities doing their work, and the courts are equally doing their work. And that's why people are full in our correction facilities, because that's a system that we have for ourselves. And it's surprising that people who are aspiring to be presidents don't even understand how the institutions of governance work, and can't have even confidence to It is so many years of independence, we should be thinking only a foreigner can come and sort out your problem. What kind of inflated complex is that? So we are at war with criminals who are terrorizing people. Yes, we are. And we shall continue to be. And we are saying, please avoid riotous behavior because we are damaging government property. And I've said to Zambians, when you damage a police in Chembe, you are not just chasing the police. And a medical officer who has to look after your health in Chembe needs to be in an environment which is secure and safe, where they feel protected. A teacher wants to be in an area where they are safe and can feel protected. So when you damage police, you are not just chasing the police, you are chasing all these government functionaries away from your area. And you are just allowing criminals to have a red carpet to terrorize you. Because they're the only ones who thrive in the absence of security. So we are focusing, you have seen, we are building houses for our men and women in uniform, which hasn't happened in so many years.